I'm Joe LaRocca with here with co-MC Amber Bradley. We're back. When we look at shrinkage around the country, retailers lost an estimated 1.33% of sales, or $46 billion in 2017. A staggering number. And the causation, we know that external crimes outpace internal crimes for the first time in 4 years. The good news is that retailers continue to deploy new technologies to address both customer service and reduce shrinkage in stores, and we're really excited about that. And
just the good news network, I think.
We're the good news network.
Can we adopt that name? I'm not sure.
Maybe.
There is good news in loss prevention, folks.
Facts matter.
We're here to bring it to you. I think we are. Well, especially today. I mean, there's lots of different technologies that are doing just what you're saying.
That's right.
You know, I mean, shrink is a big number, but if you can implement some technologies that help the sales number.
That's right.
Surprisingly, our shrink number isn't so bad.
That's right.
See?
The shrink, the percentages go down. So we're excited by a guest that will join us in just a minute. We will have Larry Reed, the CEO of ZK Techco, who will be coming into the picture in just a minute. I think it's exciting. ZK Techco is their first time here at the LPNN, so
we have to make them feel welcome.
We'll make them feel welcome.
With the hot seat.
I think we should put them on. We should get to know the company a little
bit,
right?
We should get to
because
know.
We want to know what ZK Tech
down
is all
deep.
About. But we want to get to know Larry a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We need to know, because who's going to do business with somebody they have no idea who they are?
And he's not here yet, so he has no idea this
He has
is
no
coming.
Idea. I need to know, if I'm going to do business with you, if you have an afternoon off, what are you going for? Ellen or Oprah? I need to know that. It's in a window into your soul.
NFL or MLB.
Yeah. It's important.
Right?
New York or L.A.?
New York or L.A.
We know what your choice. Exactly. What's your choice? Knowing that you're in the Big Apple?
I'm born New York, raised in California. So it's actually a tough question, but California's home.
Oh, California's home.
California's home. L.A.
Well, you got to go where your heart is,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and where the weather's better.
Where the weather's better. We're not freezing.
Sorry,
walking
everybody.
To Starbucks. But hey, you can't beat NYC in the Big Apple.
No, not at all.
And you can't beat the industry's only digital fast break conference. I know, we promised our sound guy we wouldn't.
It's only taken 7 seasons to get that right.
I know,
right?
And we're doing it together, and I love it. I think that's our new thing, especially as we lean into it.
Right.
I'm a big fan of that. Almost as much as our hashtag screen we have right off camera that's showing us all of the questions that you're posting via Twitter.
That's right.
Which is blowing up.
That's right.
We'll get to some of those in a minute.
Did you know, I took some cool behind the scenes photos earlier.
Oh, yes. So if you're not following LaRocca J, you better get on that.
I didn't say I posted them. I just say I took them.
Posting them throughout the year.
How about I post them today during the next break, and then you can see sort of what happens behind.
Yeah. I think everyone's curious. You know, it's that
cameras,
Paul Taylor
lights.
Swift thing.
Well, you know what? Here, if you're in New York City, why don't you come on down here right now?
Come on down.
We're at the Manhattan Club. We have plenty of room. There's a group of people already here watching what's going on.
We have hot coffee.
We have snacks.
You always have snacks.
I have snacks.
You might see Joe and myself noshing on the Oreo cookies that you bring. The same ones?
That's right.
Same ones you brought you?
A little different.
A little different. Okay, that's okay.
Hey there.
Hey, we have a guest. How are you?
Doing?
Get in here.
Boring competitors at this show, I promise you.
Get in here. Get in here.
We've got some really cool technology.
I know. Step up to the hot seat table.
Well,
we want to hear about it, Larry. So, first of all, welcome to the D&D.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yes.
I'm really enjoying this.
Well, good.
Unbelievable.
Isn't he?
He's my new mentor.
Oh,
absolutely.
How about that?
Absolutely.
That's huge.
Good.
Joe's my mentor, but, you know. Okay, Larry, so we were just talking about how amazing technology can help both the sales number in retail, which automatically helps our shrink number go down.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
So Joe and I were just peeking into your last session there, talking about some of these biometric solutions. So tell us about some of the hottest, newest things you guys have right here at the D&D Hot Table.
Well, you know, it's something that a lot of the LP folks, granted, they're so busy, and I know that I'm not top on their priority and not necessarily looking for innovation, right? But when you mention biometrics, they look kind of hazy. If I tell anyone to take out their cell phone everyone's got either a fingerprint reader. Now, the only reason my cell phone doesn't have a fingerprint reader is because it has a face camera instead.
Oh, nice.
You know? So biometrics actually has reached the consumer. So if they want biometrics to protect their photos, yeah. Wouldn't an LP person want to protect millions and millions of dollars of inventory?
Of course.
You know?
Yes. And so Joe, my esteemed co-MC, has had an illustrious career as an LP executive. So talking about biometrics and your LP take on them, Joe. I mean, so this is what happens at the quick take table.
Now you're putting him on the spot.
No, I do all day.
He does all day long.
All day long. That's why he's here. And a Ring of Excellence winner. That's number one plug of that.
Thank
we
you.
Do that every year. So Joe is kind of a big deal for us.
Stop.
But so, Larry, that's what we do. We cut through all the marketing speak here at the hot table at the D&D, right? So, Joe, talk about biometrics. And we're going to get Larry to comment on it because he's got some excellent things to say, I think.
Have you seen any biometric readers deployed in any of the retail stores?
They are deployed at retail stores and have been. I think, so my question for you, right, is since some people may not know ZKTeco and the company,
mm-hmm. Right.
What is it that you actually connect to? Are you selling hardware? Are you a software solution? What is it you're applying into stores?
Right. Well, I'll tell you what we're not applying is being disruptive, because most older stores, they already have an access control system. Mm-hmm. They're already controlling the doors. If they should be controlling the doors with at least electronic access, like a card reader. Right. So we're not asking them to change that at all. In fact, our biometric readers, they all have card readers built inside them. You don't even have to tell them there's a biometric if they don't want to use it.
Okay.
But what we're selling is the actual biometric reader. It's either a fingerprint reader or it's a face reader. And I was mentioning
just the hardware.
It's strictly just the hardware.
Got it.
And it's talking to the retailer's existing hardware and the existing software. So it's not disruptive at all. We're just adding another layer.
Great.
In fact, if they want, they can still continue using their cards, but now they also have to present that finger or they have to present their face. So again, it's not disruptive at all.
So you're saying you don't have to rip out what you already have to use your
products. We always want to protect the investment of the client.
That's what we do. Yes. Yeah.
And what are some of the sectors of retail that you're currently deployed in?
It really crosses the gamut. And because we don't sell direct to end users, we don't even really know the end users all the time because our integrators are installing. I got a phone call, Larry got another retail client. We need these requirements. Can you ship 1,000 readers there, 500 there?
Right.
So it's not anyone in specific. I can tell you, big box folks, they're really going crazy. I can't even mention some of their names.
Of course.
But they've got the big bucks as well. And when you can tell them, you could reduce even like a percentage or a half a percent of shrink. Based
definitely
on
adds up.
It's huge.
Well,
huge.
Larry, thank you so much. We really appreciate your support here at the D&D and stepping into the quick take table here and helping me put Joe on the spot. But for now, we're going to turn it back over to Gus and the D&D Daily. Thanks so much for watching.